Hello ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? Welcome to Edition Programming. So guys, for today we're looking at continuing the bottom navigation bar tutorial series. And you can see right here, this is our bottom navigation bar right here, this one that you can see. And then today our fragments that shall be showing per each particular navigation item shall consist of recyclable. Now this is what I'm talking about. You can see this is our stuff right here. Okay, so what about, of course, if I scroll, it gets hidden. Now if I bring it, now you can see right here, actually it gets shown again. Now of course we can navigate right here. You can see we have these are now our drama, a fragment right here with the data right here. Okay, so then we can also move to our documentary right here. So you can see these, actually these are fragments you are showing. Of course our fragments have our recyclables. Okay, so this is our bottom navigation bar. Remember, as of the time of writing this tutorial, there's really no official component for that except for design specifications. Okay, so what we're using right here is a library, a very nice library known as AH navigation. Okay, AH bottom navigation. So this is what we're going to see. We're going to use this particular third party library to of course show our nice bottom navigation right here. And of course we are implementing it to work with our fragment, so that if we click a particular item, we have right here our fragment, and then our fragments of course have this particular recyclable. Guys, this is what we're going to look at, so welcome, we'll get started. So guys, obviously the first thing, we have to create our project. Now go to your Android Studio file, new project, come over right here, type the application name, then go to next. We have our minimum SDK, choose yours, mine is API 15. And of course we have templates, I'm going to go with blank activity, then you click next, then you click finish. This is going to generate for us our project. Now the very first thing I said, we're going to use a third party library, and now because of that one, of course also we shall also be using actually recyclable. Okay, so for recyclable we shall need this particular design support libraries, and then of course we also need card view. So please make sure that you add this one, you're specifying your SDK version, and then of course also make sure that you add this particular AH bottom navigation. This is the library we're using. Okay, it's what shall enable us implement this particular bottom by navigation. So please make sure you add this one. This one is going to require for us the internet connection. Now once you've added it, come over right here, then click this sync. This is going to async our project. Okay, so that's it guys, that's it. Now that's what we set up over there. We're going now to move to our resources. Now for our resources, because we shall need to display this particular navigation bar, we need some stuff. For instance, we need the images that we're going to be showing as the icons. Those are the icons that you are seeing. Myself, I have three of them. You can see these are my images, these are what I'm going to be showing. Okay, so that's it. Please add your drawables that you shall be showing. Now once you've done that one, of course Android Studio shall generate for you these two, activity main and of course the content main. Okay, so our content main is going to remain empty, except that inside it, please specify the ID for this particular relative layout. Why are we doing that one? Okay, we're doing that one because remember, we shall be showing our fragments. Now this shall act as the container for our fragments. Okay, so this is what shall be replacing with our fragment layouts. So please make sure that you specify its ID. For me, mine, I've just also maybe made some customizations, giving it this particular one DP. Okay, so that's it, that's our content main. Then we also have our activity main. So for the activity main, what we require is very simple. We just, of course we know very well, right here we have our coordinator layout at the top, then inside it we have the upper layout, then of course we have our toolbar. But then inside the upper layout, then we're including our content main inside this activity main. So the only thing I require you to add over right here is this particular stuff right here. Okay, this particular XML stuff. So please make sure that you add this one and then make sure that you specify its ID. This is the view that shall help us to display our bottom navigation bar. So please make sure you add it and specify the ID. Okay, so guys, those are the two layouts, of course, that AndroidStudio generates for us. Now the next three, these are our fragments. Okay, so remember, we're going to have three fragments. By the according to the material design specifications, actually this bottom bar navigation actually suitable for displaying like around 3 to 5 items. Okay, so if you have something like more than five, you'll consider your options with another maybe view. But then if you have less than 3, then also maybe you can use the tabs. Okay, it's good for displaying like 3 to 5 items. It's not a good design, for instance, to try to cram like 10 view items inside a bottom navigation bar. Okay, it's around 3 to 5. So that's it. Now for us, these are the three, actually these are our fragment layouts. We shall be showing fragments when a user clicks a particular view navigation item. Like for me, I'm going to have, of course, my first fragment right here. You can see it's call it crime fragment. I've just given it okay, I've included in it a recycler view, okay, because we shall be showing recycler view. So I've given it its unique ID right here. Then we also have our documentary fragment. I've also given it an ID. I've called mine docs RV. Okay, so these are the recycler view in which shall be displaying our items. Now we also have our drama RV right here. These are our views, guys. Now the last one is our model. Remember, this is a recycler view. Okay, so this is the way my model shall appear. Okay, so what do we mean by model? We simply mean the way each particular view item inside our recycler view shall appear. Like for instance, as far as you can see, we are just going to include a simple text view. Now at the top, of course, we have our card view, then we have a relative layout, and then of course in wrapping, this is our name txt, which is our text view. So this is it, this is our stuff right here. Now for me, this is my code right here. I've given some properties, card corner radius, card elevation, etc. So guys, these are the layouts. You need to prepare your layouts because we're going to need all these. Now once we've done that one, the next thing, we're going to move to our code. So to our code, the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to create a package right here. My first package, I'm going to call it mfragments. This is where I shall have my fragments, okay. And then I'll also add another package that I'm going to call, let me call this one mRecycler. This is where I'm going to have my recyclable stuff. So if we start with the mFragments, let's come. What do you need right here? We need three classes. We need three fragments. My first fragment, I'm going to call it crime fragment. Of course, it's a class, is derived from the fragment class, okay, but then we'll be using the support library fragment. Then we also have our drama fragment, and lastly we have our documentary fragment. So we come over here and then add our documentary fragment. This is going to do for us, guys. This shall act as our three fragments. Now we'll come to them in a short while. Now the very first thing after okay, let's also come to our package, recycler package. So this is right here, we shall have code dealing with the UI stuff, our recycler view. Now for us, I'm going to have two classes. Of course, my first one, I'm just going to call it a simple name like my holder, and then of course that one shall be our view holder class. Then our adapter, I'm just going to call it my adapter. Okay, very simple names. So these are the things. Now right here, this is our class right here, is going of course to derive from a recycler.view holder. Then let's come to our crime fragment. Now the first thing I said, we have to make sure these ones derive from fragment because they are our fragments. Okay, I'm using the support library fragment. What we're going to do, let's come over right here. Of course, the first thing that we're going to need right here, we need to come right here and then override our own create view method. So we come, we override this particular method. Now this method shall return a view object that's going to represent a single view or a single row in our recycler view in this case. So then that particular view, we shall get it by inflating a layout, a fragment layout. Okay, so for us, for instance, in this case, I'm going to call it root view. Then we inflate it. Of course, we are being passed a layout inflator instance. We call this inflate method. Then we pass in the layout that we want to inflate. Now, add layout. For me, it's my node model layout. Remember, this is inside our fragment. So, for me, this is crime fragment. Okay, this is layout that we're inflating shall represent our fragment. So, that's it. No crime fragment. Now, what about our view group? Okay, parent. This shall be the parent. No, it's container. Okay. And then, shall we be attaching it to a root view? Some root view? No. Okay, this is of course our root view. We shall just return it. This is it. Then of course we have it. This is what we are going to return. Okay, so yes, we've done that one, but then we're dealing with the recycler view. So let's come over right here. First, we need to reference a recycler view. So we're going to come right here, RV recycler view equal to R5. In fact, this I recommend that let's suppose right here, and then let's go and deal with the recycler stuff first. Okay, so that if we come to each particular fragment, we just come and finish with it. So let's come over right here. We're going to start with the my holder class. So my holder class, this is going to hold for us the view items that shall be displaying in a recycler view. In this case, for me, I'm just going to have, of course, we have to derive from our view holder class. So come right here, say recycler view dot view holder. Okay, so with this one we have to create a constructor, and then here we have it now, which is this particular widget that we want to display in this particular in our view. Of course, for me it's a text view. That's the only thing I want to display. So we're going to come over right here, then reference it. Now come and say name txt equal to item view and find view by id. So then we pass in id. Now r dot id dot what main I think was name txt. Okay, so we imported this one. This one should be name txt, and then of course we have to cast this one from a view object to a text view. That's it. This is our view holder class. You can see it's very simple. It's a very simple class. It's just holding for us this particular view that we shall be recycling. Now we come to our my adapter. So inside our adapter, the first thing we're going to derive from our recycler view dot adapter, the type we pass my holder class. So yes, we're going to have to implement these three methods on create view. This is one we shall be returning our view holder instance, and then of course passing it inside our own bind view holder. We shall be binding our data. Get item count of course returns for us the total number of items. Now we're going to need context. Okay, and then maybe we shall also need maybe a string array. Okay, so for me, this string array, I'm just going to call it movies. We're going to get them over our constructor. So we come over right here. They get passed. We assign them to these local views. Now, inside our my holder class, what we're going to do, we're going to create a view object, okay, by inflating our layout. So we're going to use our layout inflator class to do so. Now come layout inflator. Of course, we call it's from method. Then we pass in the context. Now context parent.get context. Okay, just give us our context, and then of course we call our inflate method once more. Now r okay dot I know it's the layout of course that we are trying to inflate. So dot layout dot model. Okay, remember this same round we're just inflating the individual views, not a fragment or anything. Okay, inflating actually the items for our recycler view. So that's it. Now we come over right here, our view group of course shall be parent and then false. Okay, so yes, we have this. Then now what we need to return, we need to return my holder instance. So we just come over it here and say return new my holder, then we pass in this particular view object. So our my holder instance shall be passed to our own bind view holder, okay, alongside the position. So what we're going to do, we're going to use these ones to get the current item, and then of course I'll show it inside our text view. So come over right here and then say holder, which is our my holder instance dot name txt. Then we call the set text method. Now we need to pass the name over right here. So this particular name, of course, we get it from our array. Now we just pass in the index right here. Of course, our index is position. Our array is, of course, type string. So that's enough for us. What about the get item count? Okay, the length of our moves by just calling the length. So guys, this is our adapter, my adapter, a very simple class. So yes, we can now come and then continue with our crime fragment. Now we can come right here, say find, okay, we want to reference a recycler view. We have to use this view object to find it. Now find view by id, then we pass in the id. Now r.id, we inside our crime, so we pass in our crime id, crime rv. That's it, and then we have to cast this one from a view to a recycler view. So that's it guys, we have our recycler view. What about some of its properties? For instance, of course, we have to set its layout manager. So we come, I'm going to use the linear layout manager. So for a linear layout manager, we now need to pass in the context. Okay, how do we get the context? Yet we're inside our fragment class. Now to get our context, we just call get activity so that we get the activity hosting this particular fragment. Okay, that's going to be our context. So yes, because the hosting activity right there. So that's it. Now once we have that one, we need now to come and then deal with the adapter. So we come first, of course, instantiate it and call it adapter equal to new my adapter. We need to pass in the context, though we didn't even make use of it inside our my adapter class. But then if you wanted to show a toast, for instance, this context will be important, okay, or some other things. But then let's just pass it once more. We pass the activity hosting this fragment, then we pass in our data source. Now what's our data source? We come right here, I'm going to type my data over right here. I'm going to call it crime. Okay, then I type my data over right here, and yes, this is my data. This is what I'll be binding to actually my recycler view. So then I come, yes, I pass that particular data, and that's it. Of course, we need to set this particular adapter to our recycler view by calling our set adapter, then we pass in our adapter. This is it. This is our crime fragment. What we're going to do, we're going to use it as a template for the other fragments because it's very similar. So let's copy paste this one over here and then bring it over right here. Let's start with the documentary. Now first, of course, we have to make it derive from fragment. He said you're using the support library. So we come, we have this one. Now the only thing we need to come right here and define our array. Okay, our data source, I'm going to call it docs, then also I type it here first. So guys, this is my data. Of course, you can see it right here, documentaries. Then we come over right here. Of course, the first thing, please don't forget this one, come right here, set your layout. What's my layout in this case? Okay, we inside our documentary. So I'm going to use the documentary fragment. That is the layout for the fragment. Then we come, we have our recycler view. What's its ID? No, my ID is docs rv. And then of course, what's my data source? My data source is this docs. That's it, guys. This is it. This is how we do our stuff. Now, this is it. We're through with our documentary fragment. So then we come also borrow the same thing and then come right here first, extends, and then we make it extend our fragment support library. Then we come right here, and then just add this one. Now once more we need to define our data source, and for me it's just a simple array for simplicity. This time round I call it a drama, then I type it. So guys, here I am. Now we come over right here. What's our layout? Our layout this time is the drama fragment. Okay, layout. So then we come, what's our ID for our recycler drama RV? Please make sure you get these particular IDs and layouts right. Then of course, what's our data source? Is this drama array. Guess this is it. These are our fragments. Okay, that's how we do. Now the next thing right here, we're going to come to our main activity. So inside our main activity, the first thing we're going to need the AH bottom navigation declaration right here. So let's come right here, AH bottom navigation. I'm going to call it a bottom navigation. We just declare it there. So then of course we come reference it from right here inside our on create method equal to find view by ID. We pass in our ID. Now for me, my ID of course is going to be, I called it my bottom navigation ID. Of course we cast it and then that's it. So yes, we have it, but then we need to create the navigation items. Remember this is just like now our bar. Okay, we need to create navigation items and then add this to this our bottom navigation bar. To do so, we're going to use a simple method right here. Come over and say private void. I'm going to call it create nav items, because that's what we're going to do. So how do we create our navigation items? Okay, for our navigation items is very simple. We have the AH navigation item class that we're simply going to instantiate. So we come right here, AH navigation item. Now my first item, I'm going to call it crime item. Of course we just instantiate it, AH navigation item. Now we need to pass in two stuffs right here, two parameters, of course the title and of course the ID for our image resource. So what's our title? For me, my title is going to be crime. Now then, what's our ID? Now our ID actually are drawable, so r.drawable dot this time round I'm going to use what? Yeah, crime. Okay, so that's it. Okay, that's it. Then of course we're going to copy paste this one and then come reuse it over right here. So this, the first one was the crime, the second one is going to be drama, the third one is going to be a documentary. So for documentaries I'll have DR, for this one I'm going to have AC. Okay, that's it. Now but let's not forget this one. So we come our title. Now our title of course is drama. Of course right here my, I'm going to call it docs. By the way, if you type a long name right there, then automatically it will just display the icons only. Okay, so if you want it, though there is a method that you can call to force it to display also the text alongside the title. But then if you read the material design documentation for this particular component, is not something recommended. Okay, so it's not something recommended. So that's it. We're just going to pass in short names. It's display them automatically because they are short, they can fit in. So what's next? Of course we've just created our navigation items. Now we need to add them to our navigation bar. So how do we do that one? We have a navigation bar right here. We simply call the add item, then we add each particular item. Okay, so that's it. We add the first one, of course, our crime item. We're also going to have right here the drama item, and lastly the docs item. Okay, and that's it. We've added the items. Maybe we may want to play with some properties right here. Now if you want to access some of the properties, just come navigation. Okay, now for instance, for me I'm just going to call the set default background color. So then I come, I pass my color by calling pass color right here, then we pass our string. So for us of course right here we are going to our ways. Okay, So then we're just going to have maybe some whitish color. Okay, now guys, you can set the lot of properties. You can just access them. For instance, if you come right here, you can see stuff like set accent color, set color. There are so many properties. You can scroll down, try experiment with them. For us, this is enough. Okay, we just set this particular single property. So guys, what we'd like is very simple. We want that after creating our items, now the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to make sure that we select the first item inside our list. So how do we do that one? We come, call our bottom navigation, that we set our current item, we pass in the position. Okay, so this is it. This is what we're going to do. Now we shall just simply come right now and then call this dot create nav items. But then remember, we've not yet connected actually our fragments with our navigation items. We need to do that one. Now that one is quite easy. We shall come right here. First we're just going to implement. Okay, let's come right here, implements ah bottom navigation, then we're going to implement the on tab selected listener. So what we are doing is very simple. Now if the on tab selected is called, okay, what that is, of course it does get called when you select a tab. Now if this is done, what you're going to do, we're simply going to show the fragment. Okay, replace our content main with our fragment. Now of course we need to do that on according to what has been selected. Luckily we have our position right here, so we're just going to come and say if position, for instance, if it is the first one, we know very well the first item we added was the crime, okay, item. So we need to show the crime fragment. Now how do we show our crime fragment? First of course we instantiate it. Now I call it crime fragment equal to okay, so yes, we have our crime fragment. We need to show it. Now we need the help of support. We need the help of our fragment manager. But remember, our fragments were deriving of course from the fragment support library. Fragment over right here, where is it? Okay, you can see support library fragment. So because of that one, we'll need to use the support fragment library to get it inside our main activity. So we just call get support fragment manager. So yes, get support fragment manager, and then we're going to call begin transaction, then we call replace method. Now what do you want to replace? You want to replace the container that we specified in our content main layout. So what was it? What was its ID? This ID was content ID. And then what do you want to replace it with? You want to replace it with our crime fragment that of course has its own layout. So we commit. So that's it. This is how we're going to do. Now this was that was in the first position. What about in our second position, where the index is 1? So we're going to come this time round, of course it's our drama fragment. So we come, and then of course drama fragment right here. Okay, let me call it drama fragment. We instantiate it, our drama fragment. So that's it. We have our drama fragment. We simply replace our content actually our content main with this particular drama fragment, and that's exactly what we're going to do also to our third one. So we come over right here. Now this time round the position is 2, of course it's documentary fragment. So documentary fragment, we make sure we instantiate it over right here. So documentary fragment, then of course we replace our container with this particular fragment, and that's it. That's how we're going to set our stuff. Remember, this on tab selected. Now what we're going to do right here, we're just going to set this particular, we've implemented this particular interface, so we want to set it to this particular to our bottom navigation item. We've not yet done so. So to do that one, remember we want to make sure that we do it so that by the time this particular set current item is called, we've already set our tab click listeners. Okay, so then we come right here, say bottom navigation dot set on tab selected, then we pass this meaning an instance of this particular class. This does it. That's what we do. Okay, now we're just going to run our project so that we have a look. And guys, here we have our fabulous app. Now you can see right here automatically our crime fragment has been selected. Okay, so of course we can scroll. Now if we scroll right here, you can see our bottom and navigation bar automatically gets hidden. So this is it. This is our fragment with our recycler view. Of course right here drama, we have everything right here. Okay, and then of course docs. Now I know some guys may be asking that, okay, what about the on click, on item click? Okay, that's a separate topic. We have literally more than 10 tutorials that we've discussed how to handle on item click of recycler view. So please, if you want that one, you can maybe check our other tutorials. This one was meant for navigation item. So this is it. You can see right here, guys, you can make use of something like this one in your app. But then remember, mostly 3 to 5 items. Okay, you don't want to fill this one with 10 or 2 or 1. Okay, so that's it, guys. I'm hoping you guys have enjoyed this particular tutorial. If you have, hit the like button, share this video with friends and family, and guys, do subscribe so that you don't miss any of our Android tutorials. Otherwise, take care. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.